We on behalf of the family have written to the CBI director to constitute a fresh forensic team to look into the reports prepared by the Cooper Hospital and also to give an opinion as to whether the opinion given by the Cooper Hospital can be sustained or not, or whether there are some infirmities in that report, or whether the death can be said by hanging or it can be said to be murder, that is death by strangulation. The cause of death probably in both cases will be the same, which is by asphyxiation. But if it is by hanging, also there can be murder, because even if it is by hanging, murder cannot be ruled out. And the easiest way to do death by hanging, which will be murder, is by making somebody unconscious and then hanging him from wherever he is found to be hanging. And the report will always indicate that it is death by hanging, and it can't indicate that it is suicide. Suicide is a question which only the CBI could have taken, and this AIIMS team had no right whatsoever to give any comment that it is a case of suicide and not a case of murder. This Dr. Sudhir Gupta had met me about a year back. His lawyer used to be Mr. Amarendra Sharan, a very respected senior lawyer, a very senior member of the NCP, Sharad Pawar's party. And we were in the same chamber. So when he died, Sudhir Gupta came to me and he said that now I would request you to take over all my cases, because Mr. Sharan used to regard me a lot. And it is because of that there was a lot of talk between us, and even before the matter was referred by the CBI to him, he was in touch with me, and he was all the time questioning the way in which Cooper Hospital has functioned in this matter. And when I sent him these photographs, which were taken by the sister of Sushant Singh Rajput, he immediately commented that it is death, it is by strangulation, and it cannot be said to be death by hanging. Now, if a person who can make such a casual comment, I am not saying that that casual comment was correct, but if he can make such a casual comment and later on completely upturn it, completely go in a different direction, then what credibility one can attach to a person of this kind? So I personally feel that this is a case where the Cooper Hospital had done several infirmities. There were several infirmities. A post-mortem was done at night, which can't be done without an order of a magistrate. The post-mortem did not record the time of death. Viscera was not sufficiently kept. The injuries in the body was not recorded. No comments were given with regard to the injuries of the body. So all these infirmities in the post-mortem done by the Cooper Hospital was supposed to be commented upon by the AIIMS, and not to declare that it is a case of suicide, because suicide, according to me, cannot be declared by a medical team. Suicide is only to be declared by the CBI, which is handling the matter, because a doctor, while examining the post-mortem or while doing an analysis of a post-mortem report, can at best say that it is either a death by strangulation or death by hanging. He cannot say in the second case that hanging is by suicide. So this, according to me, is a very, very serious infirmity. Action should be taken against the AIIMS team. Both the CBI should look into their conduct, who all they have been meeting in this while when they have been preparing this report, how they have been coming on the TV channels. Even the Medical Council of India should look into the conduct of this entire team and see how this team members were repeatedly coming on various channels and commenting on this team in respect of a report which they have themselves thought to be completely confidential and till date not brought out in the public domain.